Okay, I'm going to make the a touch probe for the CNC machine using this 3-pin aviation panel mat. I'm just sticking with the format of shielding everything, and luckily I've got a bit of wire that I can use to shield here. I noticed when I soldered this particular type of wire, the sleeving shrinks a little because of the heat. This might be because I'm using thin solder and keeping the iron on the core wire for too long. So this doesn't become a problem in the future. Once the wire is tin, I snip the ends down a little so I don't have too much metal exposed. I use heat shrink to neaten the joins and check that there's no shorts using the voltmeter. I soldered a crocodile clip to one wire end and crimped a ring terminal to the other. Okay, just need to decide what I'm going to use as the touch plate now. I'm going to use a piece of aluminium angle bar as the touch plate for now. Extruded aluminium is pretty flat, so variation along the piece will be minimal. And the angle will also keep the aluminium flat, but I need to taper this so it doesn't get caught on the incoming spindle. Okay, the wire that's meant to be the shield was making contact with one of the other wires. Obviously haven't done a good job here, so I'm going to pull this back and solder it. Okay, I've re-soldered it. Actually written the code here that I need to write in after I've done the probe sequence. To probe in bCNC, I had to position the bit above the area I wanted to probe and set the X, Y and Z coordinates to 0. I then set the probe along the Z direction to minus 10, although that could vary, and made sure the touch plate hadn't moved away from the soon to be incoming bit. I pressed probe, and once they made contact and stopped, I typed the command G92Z1.5 into the command line. G92 sets the position of the bit end, and Z1.5 is the thickness of the touch plate along the Z axis. I then raised the bit, removed the touch plate, and moved the spindle to the new origin.
That's moved down onto the wasteboard.
I then used my feeler gauge to check the remaining distance between the wasteboard and the bit, and re-inputted the G92 command with the difference.
Thinnest one, which is 0.01. So if I write G92Z0.1 now, it should move down a little bit further. That doesn't go in. That's 0.1. Let's try the thinnest one, 0.02. Just catching ever so slightly. That's bang on. Just measure that again. So it's 1.49. So there, 1.52.
I may have not held the aluminium touch plate down well enough, but the thickness does vary slightly, as can be seen by the vernier caliper measurements. Alternatively, I could look out for a gauge block and use that as a touch plate. Anyway, don't forget to sacrifice a thumb, and thanks again for watching.